In the Innovation Hub, we've been working to add AI services to ODA components. And the first stage is we've added tools to an ODA component to make the tools available towards an AI agent. So to give the AI agent agency to use that ODA component. And for the next few minutes, I can share what those tools look like, what it enables you to do. So on my screen, I have one of the reference example components. These are available in the TM Forum ODA GitHub repository. And in this reference example component, this is a product catalog and management example component. And if I look at the exposed APIs, you can see now we've added a new exposed API following this MCP server API protocol. So at this endpoint, there is an MCP server that allows you to interact. And effectively, this is a wrapper on top of the TM Forum product catalog management open API. And if I want to use this, I can connect to this component using any MCP client application. And I'm going to be testing it using Claude Desktop. So I'm in Claude Desktop, and what you can see when I connect to that MCP server, in Claude Desktop, it has a series of tools. And I can have a look, and it shows these are the standard tools that come with Claude Desktop. But you can see I've got a new tool. In fact, it's a new set of tools called Product Catalog. And this is coming from my ODA component. And if I look in Product Catalog, effectively, it's allowing me to do a create, update, delete, get on all of the resources within my product catalog. And behind each one of these, and I'll show this in more detail in a few minutes, behind each one of these is a detailed description of how to use that API endpoint so that the Claude agent has effectively an English description of using that agent. And so what I'm going to do in my demo, I just got a few prompts I'm going to use. And let me start just by saying, list all the product offerings and their corresponding prices, show the output as a table artifact. And if I do that, effectively Claude, it knows about all the tools that are available, and it's able to look at the textual description of those tools, and then from this it's able to determine it's going to call some of those APIs. And you can see, firstly, it's doing a product offering get, and then a product offering price get, because that's what I asked for. And now it's showing me this as a nice formatted table on the site. So that's my first example. And you can see I've got a series of sort of made up product offerings with prices. And I can do things like I can even get it to do some updates. So I'm going to ask it, add a one-time price of 100 USD to the standard virtual server. And if I ask it to do that, it's able to intelligently determine which APIs it needs to call in order to add that one-time price. And you can see it's decided that it needs to do a product offering price create. So it's created a new product offering price resource. Then it's got to add it to the standard virtual server product offering. And so it's done a get, and now it's doing a product offering update. So it's quickly created this product offering price resource. And now in the product offering update, it's able to add that new price. So here we are. So it's added it. This is where it is in my component. And I'll show you this in Postman just to show that it's very real. And it's added a standard virtual server setup fee, and it's a referred type product offering price. And if I look at that URL just to prove that this is all real, I've also got on my desktop, I've got Postman. And I'm running this component locally, so it's on localhost, and I haven't got any authentication, so I can just call this API, and it should be the new product offering price resource it's just created following this the standard. And it'll even do that, even if I don't use very precise language to ask for it. So I've got another query saying, add a setup fee of $100 to the business firewall solution. I'm not mentioning any of the correctly named resources, but it's still able to interpret, for that, it's effectively doing a very similar thing. So it basically says, for that, I need a setup fee is a new product offering price, and then I need to add it to the business firewall solution product offering. So it's intelligently able to look at a bit of text and then be able to create the equivalent API calls. I'm just going to dive a little bit into how it works behind the scenes before I show any more examples. So behind the scenes, this is the code for my product catalog MCP server. So I'm using the Python SDK from MCP, and effectively it uses decorators to expose the different API calls. And the important thing is actually the doc string that you use. So this doc string is the English translation of, firstly, why might you call this API? So it describes what the API is. And the agent needs to be able to construct a payload to call this API. And I've chosen this catalog to delete because this is the simplest one. So the payload is just a catalog ID. So you describe in English what the API does and what arguments it has. And so then the agent is able to intelligently say, if someone wants to delete a catalog, I'll construct a payload and call this API. And so this effectively is how this MCP tooling works. And what I've done is I've created an MCP tool exposing all the different CRUD operations. Now, some are more complex than others. So for example, if I do a GET, I want to enable it to use all of the, like the filtering and the like pagination and to choose what fields to have. So this is the tool for a category GET. And what I'm saying is, it takes all of these properties, they're all optional, so you don't have to give any of these properties. And then in the doc string, it describes in English how the agent would construct a payload to call this API. And you see in this payload, it describes what these different fields are. And even for filtering, because it's quite complex, it gives some examples of filtering. And I'll show this in practice. So if I go back to the Claude desktop, if I ask a question where it needs to use a GET with some filtering, so I say, show the categories with an active lifecycle status, it should use that filtering facility. So you see it's doing a category GET, and it's using a filter of lifecycle status active, and then it's able to show, these are the categories with an active lifecycle status. So when you're creating these tools, how you describe them in English, that's the critical part of them. And I'll show another example. So this is when I do a GET, I've added it so that it has the description to use things like filtering. Of course, when I do a create, it needs to know like the whole spec of the thing it's creating. So in my product specification create, like it just takes one parameter, which is the product specification data. But for that, you need to know the whole schema of what is a product specification. So I've taken this from the Swagger spec, and so I'm describing in English what it needs, what it means, and so that the agent's able to then create a new product specification using all this definition which came in the tool. And because it's an agent, there are some more advanced things that I can do. So for example, these agents, they know how to create diagrams. So if I say, show a diagram of all the resources in the catalog, what this should do is it should go and query for all the resources, and then it should go and create, normally they create a diagram using something like Mermaid, and it should show it on the right-hand side. And so this is my Mermaid diagram. If I zoom in, we should see, so these are all the different, well, let me change it to dark text. So I can just ask Claude to make the text in the diagram black. Yes, so these are all the product specifications, the product offers, and the product offer prices with the different classifications of all the different resources in my catalog. And I can do that for a filtered set. So if I just want to see it for the products in my Metro Ethernet services category. Now, the interesting thing with this query is the Metro Ethernet services isn't a category, it's a product specification. So I've got a query which is intentionally incorrect. But actually what you'll find is it's able to work out that Metro Ethernet services is a specification, and it'll still create the diagram. Yeah, so here's the diagram. These are my Metro Ethernet services, actually a product specification, and that's the product offering. Those are the characteristics, and that's the product offering price. Finally, I can do operations which calls many API calls. So I've created a couple of one-off charges, and I'm saying remove all one-time fees from all products. And it's able to intelligently look at that and saying, actually, I'm going to go and get all the product offering prices, filtering by the one-off. And then it's going to get each product and should then go and delete it. Yes, it's updating both those product offerings to remove the one-time fee. So it's done a product offering update for each one of those product offerings which had that one-time fee, and now it's actually deleting the product offering price resources. So a single query in your client desktop can cause it to do many, many API calls, which does ask the question, I think, that in the APIs with this sort of feature, I think the notion of having checkpoints and be able to undo operations, because if it's doing a whole load of work for me, for example, when you use the agent in things like GitHub Copilot, it has this very nice mechanism. The agent does a whole load of work, but then makes it all visible to you, and you're able to either to keep or to undo that functionality. I think if I'm going to have an agent on top of an API like this, I need the ability to, each time it's doing some update or create or delete action, I think there needs to be an undo transaction, so that when I'm using the client, I might say, oh, actually, you've done too much, or I don't like what you've done, please undo it. So that's something we need to think about when we're adding tools to these APIs. And then let me just show an example. I'm going to ask it a question of something which it actually goes against the specification. And this is an example of when you're using these agents, they'll try something, and if it fails, they'll try a few different approaches. So I'm saying, add a property of color to the enterprise solution catalog. Now, that's not an allowed property in the specification. But what it should do, it should try a few different approaches of how can I add color to that product specification. So the first thing it will try to do is do a product specification update. And I think it'll try and add something with color. Oh, no, actually, it's very intelligently realized that it can't do that. And so it's added a characteristic of color to the product specification. And now it's using that specification to update the product offering to have a specification of color. So actually it realized that what I was asking it to do wasn't available in the spec, and it's very intelligently worked out that if you want to add a color to a product offering, you need to add a color as a characteristic to the specification, and then you can add color as a characteristic to each individual offering. And this is it just shows like the intelligence of the agents. When you give them these tools in this agency, they're able to interact with the APIs very intelligently. And my very final question is, it works also in any language. So I can ask it questions in any language. So I'm just going to ask the question of the one around showing all the product offerings and their corresponding prices and show the output as a table artifact in French. And it should be able to interpret that. And these language models, they're brilliant at translation. And it's able to work out, for that, I'm going to call the product offering get and product offering price get. So it didn't matter that it was described in a different language. And now it'll create a nice table with those details. And it's showing here is the table, and you can see it's left the name of the product as it was, but it's done a translation for everything else in the catalog. So that's my demo of adding tools to a TM Forum open API. This is just the very first stage, and this is just our initial experimentation. It seems to work really nicely, like having a really strong standard with a strong data model and standard patterns for how you interact with APIs has made it very easy to expose these as tools. There's a lot more work we can do. I'm going to plan next to do some sort of demonstration cutting across multiple different APIs. And then the next thing we can do in the Innovation Hub is we're not just adding tools to expose an API towards an agent, we're actually going to embed an agent in a component. And this is already underway. So the first agent we're doing is we've embedded AVA, so the TM Forum AI Assistant, as an agent, and we've packaged it as a component. And then you can have a different interaction with that. So when you have an agent calling tools, the agent uses the tools. If you build an agent into the component, you can actually have a more of a two-way conversation. So you can ask the component to do things, and the agent inside a component, for example, could ask clarifying questions and then have an even more intelligent conversation with these different components. Okay, thanks for listening.